Hello, everybody, and welcome to Encounters USA. This is our special Bigfoot search, Okanagan County, and we are on our seventh episode. We have already done a number of different exercises, both amphibious and on the land, in the day and at night. We have interviewed two local residents, and we are now getting ready to go into what we call our night skies observations. Then that means we're going to sit by the side of the lake and we are going to see just what is going on. So let me start out by saying that it is just going to be a night of observing the skies and seeing if there is something unusual up there. But when things even begin, it all starts off a little bit strange because I hear the sound of a definite wood knock.
So from this direction, I definitely heard a tree knock. And I don't know what it... Anyway, I turn this on just... I'm going to leave it on just for a second. Just in case there's another one, but definitely a tree knock. Like wood on wood. So interesting.
Now, is this a result of my earlier efforts to arouse Bigfoot by doing my Bigfoot calling on the lake?
So, still trying to... listen for another tree knock. Pretty weird. Maybe just a piece of falling wood. Anyway, see if it happens again.
I couldn't be sure, but I was sure that that was a wood knock, and it was far enough away from the camp to know that it could not have been any human being. And in the end, I reasoned it was just a branch falling, and I eventually let it go.
Interesting noise behind me. Now, there's the noise, and I just heard a noise to my left where I heard a tree knock a few minutes ago.
Soon I was going to be occupied, however, by other goings-on at the lake, and let me start off by saying that I had my suspicions aroused earlier on when I was interviewing Donovan and Jay, and they told me that they had seen, on their way to the camp, they had seen an Air Force vehicle full of people, and it was just sitting on the side of the road. And so let me start off by saying that I thought that what I was looking at, or was going to start looking at, had something to do with the Air Force, and these people were just there to set up some kinds of tests.
What is that? Now, I've been seeing these lights. I saw a flashing light to my left about 10 minutes ago. What is that? Oh, I'll keep an eye on it. So, whatever this is, I can see these with my naked eye. There was the one, and now they appear to be all over the horizon. This is looking east. Pretty unusual. Are these streams of mist? They're lights. I can see the lights. could that be? Well, I'm glad I got to record this. Well, hopefully that's down in the Columbia. So it's probably got something to do with their light system down there. We'll see. Now you can see they're filling up the... That must be a show or something. Definitely weird, but I'm sure there is a human explanation for it. They started over here. It's really crazy stuff. Well, look how bright it's getting.
As the night begins to wear on, I begin to get more and more convinced that what I am looking at is actually a series of searchlights, or some kind of plasma lights or something. But, you know, I've seen searchlights when I was in the military. I've seen flares, and I could not understand what these things were. And I've lived in Alaska, seen the northern lights. I've never seen them near the ground. And so the northern lights were always up in the sky, and these were not in the sky. And if you want to know about my physical location, I am basically in the mountains on a lake in the mountains. And that means there is nothing around me. There's no one around me. And about 10 miles away, down the mountain, down a steep slope, there is the Columbia, or the beginning of the Columbia River in northeastern Washington state. So that is my geographic location. And I'm sitting here on this lake by myself. There's nobody around. There's really not much around, other than me. I mean, there's no towns or anything for at least 10 to 20 miles. So I'm sitting here on this lake and I'm watching this, and I'm really beginning to think that the Air Force was moving equipment in during the day, and they were conducting an experiment with these lights or some kind of illumination devices. But as things were to go along through the night, I was going to start to get more and more concerned.
So, wow, look at that. Now we've got a straight line across there. And if you ask me, see, they're up there on the hill now. If you ask me, I'd say they're... I mean, there's a hill on the other side of this. But I think they're coming for me. I mean, I think they're surrounding me. So, isn't that strange? But yeah, it looks like there's definitely something odd going on here. And it really looks like it's just surrounding me. So that does sound really odd and crazy, I know, but... Look at that. Well, we'll keep watching and see what happens. But it's just changing every second, pretty much. Wow. What are these? What are these? Look at that. I thought it was dying down. Well, I'm just going to keep an eye on this, I guess.
Now, once I had realized that these things had really nothing to do with me, and they actually seemed to be just kind of being erratic, and they began to form into different geometric shapes. And once again, nothing that I could ever have even dreamt of being a witness to. And so glad that I was able to record these on my Psionix Aurora Pro night vision camera, because if I didn't have it, I did have my phone with me, and I put it on a tripod, and I did start to take time-lapse shots, and here are a few of them. And I mean, they are unbelievable. I mean, they're just, what is going on here? But I mean, between these and the shots that I took with my Psionix night vision camera, these are just absolutely phenomenal. So anyway, these are, this is what I was looking at, and this is what I saw, and you have to come to your own conclusion. Is this really the Northern Lights, or is it something else? Because there really appears to be something else going on here. So anyway.
Now, this one just appeared out of nowhere, basically, so no clouds to hide behind. I don't know how it just appeared.
So that is what we saw, and that was our night skies watch for the night, and we are going to come back for two more episodes because we need to go ahead and we need to break camp in the morning, and we need to go and see what the results of our trail cameras were. So let's just say that it's going to be an interesting rest of the night. And if things go well, tomorrow we'll have something on our trail cameras and we'll be able to see what exactly is out there in the woods and maybe that made that wood knock. All right then, everybody. So until our next episode back here in Okanagan County looking for Bigfoot, remember on Encounters USA, always don't forget to subscribe. That's right. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And after you do, start watching your back. We'll be right back.